Okay, so the next variation on the chakra layout is called a goal balancing layout or a Dao's chakra layout, when you're working on a goal that's been agreed between yourself and your client. Okay, so in this case we have to do with traveling for Brian, and so that's kept in mind, that goal is set before you actually do the dowsing for each chakra. And so what's happening is that each chakra will be modified slightly towards achieving that goal. So the process is very much the same. Having set the goal, we look at a grounding stone. So I've just checked what's called a standard grounding stone, so I'm looking probably at a black one. Okay, and we put the grounding stone in place, and then moving up to the root chakra with a goal in mind. Do we need a warm colour stone? No, cool. Green stone. Okay, so just picking a stone intuitively, then checking with pendulum, is this stone okay? Yeah. And so placing the stone between the upper legs, just above the knees, as the root chakra. So, second chakra, with the goal in mind, do we need a warm colour stone? No, cool colour stone. Green, turquoise, blue. So intuitively picking a blue colour stone, is this correct? And then on the second chakra, blue stone. So moving up to the solar plexus, balancing for this goal, we do a warm colour stone, cool, green, blue, turquoise. So onto the solar plexus, turquoise stone up to the heart chakra. We need a warm colour stone here, no, cool, green, yes, so green stone at the heart chakra, again intuitively choosing, this is correct, yes, into the throat chakra, cool colour stone, yeah. Green, yes, so another green stone at the throat chakra. So brow chakra, warm colour stone, cool colour stone, green, turquoise, blue, indigo correct, taking a dark blue indigo stone, is this one correct? No, so my first intuitive choice wasn't right, so looking at another dark blue colour stone, is this correct? Maybe a warm colour stone, yes. Red, a red stone up to crown. Is this one correct? So, this layout, is this correct? How much longer does we need to leave these stones in place? More than a minute? No. 30 seconds. So the stones only need to be in place for between 30 seconds and a minute, because this is very, very precise. But it's balancing each of the chakras towards achieving the goal that's been set. So when the time's up, just when you think the time's up, just double check your pendulum. Is this process now complete? Yes. And then remove the stones from the top down. Taking the grounding stone away last, and sweeping the energies of client down. So in a really nice way. And again, as before, leaving the stones to show the client afterwards.
Mm.